Welcome back again. I'm again Dr. Ajay SMLT, now presenting you the next part of your innovations and quality in thesis writing. We have covered in our earlier module the synopsis writing and writing the introduction and literature review part. Now in this module we will be discussing rest of the part of the thesis writing, like material methods, result discussion and other parts in detail. After completing this module, you will be able to write quality and effective material and methods. You will be able to use software, tips and techniques to improve the quality of writing, to frame an effective result and discussion, and write references and other auxiliary parts of the thesis. Now let us discuss material methods section. Sometimes it is combined together or sometimes it is different. Let us start with materials. Materials in sciences refers to the raw materials used for the study. These must be defined, these must be reported. What are the sources of those raw materials? What are the types and what are the sources? You must pinpoint the things, pinpoint the details, including the grades or whatever the things may be there, which may define the integrity of a complete source. Because why I am saying this? Because this type of raw material you are using is actually ensuring the credibility of your research. So regardless of the outcome, the raw materials you relied on to come to your conclusion will decide your work credibility. So credibility of the source and proper documentation of materials and sources will strengthen your dissertation or the thesis work. Do not skip minute details like name of the softwares, version, equipment, brand, model, chemical, source, software, etc. Now move to the method or methodology section. Methodology involves the process of carrying out the actual research. In case of sciences, state which method you use to prepare, synthesize, to analyze, and how did you perform it. Giving full details will help you in future and will be a quick and complete reminder of your work to you. For humanities, you should state which method you use to collect data, information, cases, sample size, etc. And explain if any randomization techniques, statistical methodology you are going to apply or you applied that thing, and whether it was qualitative or quantitative. Methodology can usually be divided into different sections depending upon the area of research. Methodology should be clear, concise and conclusive. What are the things to be kept in mind? If you are following any other author's method, you have to cite that reference, or if you are modifying it, you have to mention this, that this is the modification what you have done. If you are using animal in your study, animal study you are performing, you discuss the protocol and mention about institutional ethical committee's approval, CPC, SEA. If you are mentioning one single method, you must be specific. In case you are using multiple strategies, as we have discussed earlier also, then you must prioritize what to write first and what later. Rest of the things we have also discussed in the synopsis part. So very well known things you must not discuss. For effective presentation of methodology of for any discipline, use figure, plan, flow diagram and pictures to make it easy to understand. You can also use ray diagram and explain methodology or methodology of survey, sampling and or questionnaire setup in other discipline other than life sciences. You can use flow chart, which is a visual representation of the sequence of steps and decisions needed to perform a process. Each step in the sequence is noted within a diagram shape. You can also represent in the form of table, questionnaire setup, deciding different sample size for different conditions. You can also draw original figure or diagram by your own, or can modify the existing one by providing references. Now we move to the results. The result part is very easy to write, as it is just compilation of facts and observation, and discussing the
observed facts and data with the help of supporting papers, literature. In general practice, you can write results and discussion in two ways: write result and discussion separately, or write result and discussion simultaneously. Or there may be specific guidelines of writing the same. It depends. Or you may have to follow the instructions of your supervisor. Or if you are a supervisor, then plan it and tell your scholar to follow. But in any way, it is up to you that how effectively you can present it so that it is very easy to understand. You should guide the finding of your study in a logical sequence by using non-textual elements mostly if possible, such as figures, charts, photos, maps, tables, etc. You can start this section stating in brief that with what you have done in the study, then take the result of the experiment one by one. The sequence of putting the results should be as per methodology. And if you are little confused about certain results, just recall your research question and then decide what and in which sequence it must be written. Okay? The sequences of the results should follow the listed methodology, or you can write in order from most relevant to least important one. Now let me give you again the points to remember: that always write result section in past or past perfect tense. Make sure that each table and figure has a number and a title. There should be one single way of writing table. Focus on writing just observation and data. That interpretation, relevance and justification of observed data you can do in discussion part if you are writing it separately. Now let us focus to the infographics. What are the infographics? Table, bar diagram, diagrams, all are coming under the infographics. The result should be tabulated whenever it is feasible. Even when the result of a parameter is not of more than one set, the result of this parameter should be grouped and tabulated with the result of the same parameter for other subjects. This may also be grouped and tabulated to observe any correlation or relevancy with other different or relevant parameter. A table should possess the following parts essentially: that what is type, table should be of uniform type in thesis, layout preferably should be in the portrait one, title a brief, clear and easy to understand title, column and rows, number of divisions and subdivisions of column or rows should not be confusing, remember this thing, heading of each column or row should be very brief and complete in all respect, never skip the units of measurement when you are putting it in the title. Footnote any extra information like p-value, abbreviation, etc. for a set of data should be given in the footnote by providing asterisk or any other mark to the relevant data in the table. This is not compulsory to provide footnote to each table. Okay? Grid lines, the grid line should be clear enough to show the partition between column and rows. Sometimes hiding the grid lines make the table confusing. In tables, unnecessary color in column and row should be avoided. You can directly paste any table from MS Excel worksheet to MS Word file also. Plotting the graphs, they should be plotted using MS Excel worksheet or Origin or any other effective software. The graphs may be of various types like pie chart, they may be 2D or 3D, bar diagram, again when you are putting it in the data between the X and Y axis. This is useful in giving the direct comparison between two set of observation with same set of variables. Okay. For example, population living in different districts of a state, population in y axis and district in x axis. Initiation time and completion time of hair growth, you can mention for the standard and control in the different way. A graph has the following component and all of these should be given due attention: the data, the axis, with due care. A graph has the following component. Let's take a quick review on those things. Data in worksheet in right way, axis taken with due care, labeling with the right unit of measurement and the title, grid lines, x or y axis grid lines may be shown if desired. Legend should be clear, brief and easy to identify. The colors or the sign of legend or a set of data should be unique in a single graph. The layout and positioning legend should be uniform for all graphs. Vertical layout and bottom right positioning you have to select. The last thing is error bars. Many high impact journals demand inclusion of error bars in each line curve and bar diagram. This can be done with the help of MS Excel. While pasting the graphs, remember the things. You might be knowing this thing, that when you are pasting the graph from MS Excel to the MS Word sheet, you can paste it in two different ways. Either you put the entire sheet there or you put just in the form of picture there. If you have pasted it in the picture form, you cannot edit it there in MS Word. If you have pasted it in the form of entire worksheet, okay, there is an option when you are pasting the thing, it asks for. So if you select the entire worksheet, then you can edit without going into the Excel sheet in the worksheet itself. So it's on you how you want to paste it. So remember that this option is available for you. Utilize it. Okay. Things you should never do while writing the result part. Do not discuss or interpret your result here if result and discussion are to be discussed in two different parts. Do not manipulate the findings, because an expert reviewer can easily trace the manipulations, and this may result in the bad consequences. Even a small manipulation can make your whole work questionable and unreliable. Do not ignore negative results. Do not over actualize the findings. Do not repeat the same information. Do not confuse table with figure. Now let us move to the discussions. Discussion of a thesis is the most important part that everyone wants to read. It should be strong enough to deal with the all probable queries of readers and evaluator. And if you write it strong enough, you need not to do this exercise again for writing your research paper for the same thesis. So don't just finish it fast, take enough time to write this part. Make the most supportive research papers, read them exhaustively, frame the raw background by connecting and correlating it with your data. Discussion involves the interpretation of your research findings and its significance in the related area of research, and finally stating the additional new findings along with the existing one. The discussion part grooms your findings and enforces the reader to think critically and analyze the research problem, and of course, it brings out the space for further extension of the study. Overall, it reflects the importance of your study in the existing area. You can start by writing your research problem in brief, following importance of your study in context, write it in brief just to bring the rhythm. Okay. Mention similar studies, supporting as well as contradictory, both kind of studies must be discussed. Follow the same sequence of writing as you did in the result section. Discuss how other researchers supported your findings, supportive evidence. Okay. Mention if any clinical relevance is there. Consider alternative findings if you can justify with the supportive literature. State limitations and weakness of your study. Mention it wisely. Make suggestions for further research in brief. Lastly, concise the summary of the principal findings regardless of their significance. Now, what are the things you should not do while writing the discussions? Do not overinterpret. Interpretation should be supported by literature. Do not rewrite results. Do not add new results. Do not repeat the things, and do not criticize others. If you find anything in contrast, just mention professionally. And always support your data or interpretation with the statistical treatment. Now moving to the results and discussion, if you are writing it together, what you have to do? You can start by writing your research problem in brief, following importance of your study in context, write it in brief just to bring rhythm again. First, you have to follow the same sequence which you have mentioned in the objectives, experimental point of view. Then state the results sequentially in the form of table, graph or a figure, and start discussing immediately with the help of supporting literature. One thing you must take care, the location of table and figure must be appropriate so that one can easily connect them. Now moving to the references. References are the compilation of sources of information which you have adopted or which you have referred in your research work. The quality and quantity of references, the quality and quantity of references must be ensured for your research article. You must practice writing in particular style, observe it and practice it. Refer good quality journals. With respect to quality, quantity, distribution, updation, coverage, and then it will have a good mix of references. Now, always remember, what are the innovation you can have it? You can use the literature management tools like Google Scholar, Mendeley, and Note for accurate referencing. Refer our further reading links for details. We have mentioned it there. It will save your time, efforts, and avoid rejections for our manuscript when we plan it. Now comes the conclusion section. In most of the thesis, after the discussion, resultant discussion, you write the conclusion. Conclusion is a brief part, sometimes written in a separate page. What you have to do? You have to be very precise in your conclusion. You can write it in three stanzas. First stanza referring to your aims and objectives, that, and then second mentioning the methods what you have adopted, and third is the resultant discussion. Very crisply you will present what is was your conclusion. At the end of the conclusion, sometimes you can put what can be the how the work can be extended in future. The future trends can be incorporated at the end of the conclusion. Now let us move to the summary part. Now you will say we have concluded, what is the summary? As you know, whenever the PhD thesis is finalized, a summary is a different set. You have to submit in 3 copies and 5 copies PhD thesis summary. Summary is very important aspect, and it is you can say it is not very concise, but it is summary of each chapter. Each chapter summary is given, put together, and it is very important because many times reviewer make the basis of his or her decision when he or she is evaluating your thesis from the summary part only. So plan the chapter wise summary or abstract and compile them. Each chapter summary should state the content or the matter discussed in the chapter. So as we discussed, that never ever take the summary lightly, because it may be the decisive parameter for a evaluator. The length of summary should be around 8 to 12 pages depending upon the number of chapters. Each chapter summary should neither be too brief nor too lengthy. At least important results must be mentioned as you provide in preparing the abstract of a paper. What things should be remembered? Overall, that style and typesetting, common use of computers, setting the margins, font, heading and subheadings, chapter titles, header and footer, paragraph setting, table and figures, equation and special characters. So overall, the thesis must be written as per the guidelines of the institute, university, or as per the instruction of the supervisor. And if there are not such guidelines, you can follow the standard format, that is double line spacing, Times New Roman font, that is in 12 font, 1-inch margin from all corners of the page. Left margin, however, you can put quite large as compared to the other margins because the binding may get the space. Now moving to the cover or title page. The cover or title page is generally standard for the university. So refer any previous years or current year thesis, put all the required things: title, your name, enrollment, subject, logo of university, year of submission, supervisor's name, and the name of the institute. Give utmost attention to the title. It must be matched word to word with the title mentioned in your registration letter. Even addition or deletion of a simple a, the, or some may lead to problem in submission. If it happens, you have to unbind all the thesis again, get the changes done, and resubmit it. This shall delay the submission only. Other auxiliary parts of reports like acknowledgement, index, appendices must be planned effectively. then final checking and proofreading should be done, then bind the thesis effectively, and it's on you and on your supervisor's discrimination that how you want to bind it and submit it now. Now let us discuss the supervisor's role. Now supervisor has got a vital role to play, and the tuning between the scholar and the supervisor is the decisive factor of the success of any research work. First, as a faculty member, you must give due time for discussion with the scholar, and the scholar should take the time, because you might be busy in various academic works. So, and if you give the sufficient time, the blunders won't be there. If any problem arises, in due time it can be sorted out when you are continually discussing the things. And any problem can be sorted out in time due to this discussion part. The reporting should be in complete form. You should carry all the raw and processed data to show the supervisor. Ask your scholar, faculty members, to be updated. Any serious problem must be discussed after a good homework. The routine reports which are to be sent to the university should be discussed. The progress reports I am talking about, they should be checked and approved. No change in work should be made without the consent of supervisor or the university. So dear friends, dear faculty members, dear professors, let me summarize this module for you. We studied how material and methods are planned. Material and methods is a section which deals with how of your research, how you performed various methods to achieve your aim and objectives. With the help of infographics, you can plan very good results and discussion. And when you are writing the result and discussion, it must conform to the aim and objectives sequentially, and the rhythm must be maintained, the clarity must be there. Use statistical techniques, suitable statistical techniques, infographics like tables, graphs, other type of bar diagrams, diagram, pictures, to give quality to your presentation. Then references must be written in a uniform style, and the reference management tools like EndNote, Mendeley must be used for the effective and precise presentation of references. The conclusion should be precise one. Summary should be planned very effectively, chapter wise, with the crisp presentation. And the other auxiliary part like title page, acknowledgement, list of table figure, etc., must be planned as per the instructions and as per the guidelines. And the role of supervisor is very important. As a supervisor, you must have a good tuning with your scholars. Because it is a time, you might have seen that plagiarism bill is there. Okay, if anything wrong happens, maybe your scholar has done it, but you will have to face the consequences. So be alert, give due time to your research scholar. And if you are doing the PhD, be in good tuning with your supervisor, in good discussion, you can give better results and quality thesis you can prepare. So best of luck for your research endeavors, and as I always say, please do refer the further links, they have been selected for you. And if you have any problem, you can come and discuss with us in discussion forum. Thank you. Happy learning.